It is day 5 of Purple Train. I've had no sleep all week, but I'm still excited, still wearing the purple shirts. And this morning, I'm at Moorgate / Liverpool Street station as we continue our deep dive into all the stations. Now, there's a lot of lifts, a lot of step-free access to check out here, which is why Sarah, morning.
Morning.
Has turned up to help me. All right.
Hello.
Signage, what are you thinking?
Yes.
Can you see sign to the lift?
I can see two lifts. There's a lift going back there and there's one over there.
Which is for the Elizabeth line?
I don't know. I haven't worked that out yet.
It's that one because there's the purple, so it must be that one, right?
Okay. Do you know, it'd be so much better if it had a line on the floor.
Ooh.
You know, like a special purple line.
I mean, I think TfL will watch this and see you say that.
Yeah.
So already, feedback. Now, some of you might be asking, hang on, Jeff, if this is a Liverpool Street video, why are you at Moorgate? It's the classic thing, because the Crossrail stations are so huge, capacious. The eastern end of Liverpool Street Crossrail is at Liverpool Street, but the western end stretches all the way here to Moorgate. What's really interesting about that is that it means that it is then connected to both on the tube map. But what's really interesting is that on the tube map, it shows it being connected to both Liverpool Street and Moorgate, but on the London's Rail and Tube Services map, it only shows the connection to Liverpool Street and not Moorgate. But you can access the purple train platforms of Liverpool Street via here, this entrance exit at Moorgate.
When you come in, again, it's got the diagram of where all the different lifts are, what levels you're at, again, what the lines are with the colours, and most importantly for today, the Elizabeth line, with services towards Abbeywood, Heathrow, and Reading.
Okay, now Sarah, something I've already spotted, something interesting is going to happen here that happened with me and Reese at Tottenham Court Road. Can you see it already?
Yes.
Is it what I think it is? It's a mezzanine level.
God, yes.
So it's a split lift. So you do that lift first, and then you come along this little, I like this.
Okay.
I mean, we clearly want -9.
We do.
But -8 for the northern line. Oh, so there's another level. Do you want to do the Northern Line corridor now? Because I've just seen it, I've just worked out. On the press trip,
yeah,
I climbed up these steps, went to the top there, but never went down the corridor. So if we go back in the lift, and we go up from -9 to -8.
Yeah, so they want -1.
There.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thanks.
But we're just going to go, presumably we're going to pop out this side here.
Oh,
to -8, there we go, -8 level.
What I'm going to do,
yes,
I'm going to time it, because I think this is a really long corridor. I mean, actually, add on a few seconds for that bit there, but I just want to see how long this corridor takes to walk down. We're going to start now. It's 1 minute and I can't see the end of the corridor. And as I say that, suddenly I can see a little bend. Morning.
Good morning, Jeff.
How you doing? Thank you. How are you enjoying it?
Very well. It's brilliant.
All right. See you in a bit.
Bye.
So the corridor then bends. You found another lift.
Lift to Northern Line.
And it says lift to the left, Northern Line to the right. It's basically, it's 2 minutes. Allow yourself 3 minutes to walk that connecting corridor.
Here we come.
And where can we go from here? Just to the Northern Line. Oh, this is one of those. It's doesn't even have the level numbers.
No.
It's just a press to operate. Oh, we're right by the Northern Line. Southbound platform is there.
It's amazing.
Northbound platform is there. Escalator up to the National Rail platforms are there. And you're on the Northern Line.
Wow.
You like that?
I really, really do. Woohoo! Familiar times.
And that takes us back to the really long corridor.
Park run.
Like park run? It's so long, it feels like a 5k long corridor. Oh man, what is the longest interchange corridor on the tube or the TfL map? It could be this one. It's not about Sarah. There's a couple of people here. The gentleman, you've been on the train, but Casey, this is a genuine your first moment. I want to capture your natural reaction because you've not been on the platform and seen
hi
it yet,
everyone.
Right? Just say hi to YouTube.
Hi to YouTube.
I want to get your natural reaction. Ready? Ready? Yeah. This is it.
If you could gasp, that would really help.
This is amazing. It's very clean.
It's clean?
Yeah.
But it's brand new, I'd hope so.
Exactly. It's amazing.
Okay.
I like the boards. They're very, like, fancy and up-tech. Yeah, it's great.
At this point, people normally comment on the length of the platforms.
They are quite long.
You're aware that if you go down that end, you can walk all the way to Liverpool Street, right?
Wow.
So this is the Moorgate end.
Yeah.
But down there is the Liverpool Street end. Sarah, you were saying something about wayfinding.
I was. It's so much better than I thought, because this is a vast station, but I found notices in every place I'd expect. You know, they're so regularly spaced. I love these displays over the platform edge doors and the animation. I'm finding it really easy to follow.
But how are you finding the gap? Is that an acceptable gap for you? What's that like? Is that 2 inches?
Yes. I think, yeah, that's no problem for me, and I don't think it'd be a problem for a scooter or a power chair user.
So there's signage here to indicate that if you want the bit of the Elizabeth line that is Liverpool Street to Shenfield, you have to exit this way, go up the escalators, out the gate line, onto the main high-level regular Liverpool Street station, and then pick up services from platforms 15 to 17. I am going to time that connection in a second. So this is the only one of these stations that have that. So yesterday at Farringdon, you don't have this. At Tottenham Court Road, 2 days ago, we didn't have this. But for some reason, I'm sure somebody, hi, will tell us why, but there's like a middle passageway and it goes uninterrupted all the way down. I'm guessing they expect more people to be walking between Liverpool Street and Moorgate, and so rather than have people walk the platforms, they've decided to do this corridor. Corridor? Passageway? When you say passageway, you think of a tiny 3 meter wide underground passageway. I think this deserves a better word than passageway.
Chasm, catacomb,
cathedral-esque tunnel. Come up with a word, Sarah. What would you be calling it?
All I could think on opening day was cathedral. But yeah, it's cathedral of train, the whole place.
Cathedral of train.
Yes.
It's amazing who you meet whilst walking the corridors Liverpool Street. In my case, I've met the CEO of MTR UK division. MTR, Steve, are actually the people who do what? Because people just see it as TfL.
Yeah,
it's actually run by MTR, isn't it?
With the operators. TfL are the clients, so they've created this project. They've been our partners all the way through. We're here to operate the service on behalf of TfL, which is a great honour, of course.
And you're just checking out your own railway today? Like, what are you doing here?
Well, this is just the best place to be, isn't it? And actually, all the way through, I've been watching your stuff on social media for years.
You're very kind, thank you.
And your support, actually, of the whole project has been amazing.
Even when I call it Crossrail and not Elizabeth Line.
Yeah, we'll allow that. No, it's been brilliant, so really appreciate that.
You're letting that one slide.
Yeah, completely. Because as railway people, we've loved the fact you've been supporting us all the way through. We finally got here.
What's not to love about railways?
Absolutely.
If you agree, put that in the comments. I want to see like 1,000 people type the phrase, what's not to love about railways?
Absolutely. Okay. I'm with you.
I have only one tricky question to test you out.
I'm not so good on tricky questions.
Okay, my beloved friend Sarah is about to go up to street level.
Yeah.
Is it an inclinator? Is it a funicular? Or you had a brilliant phrase, what do you call it?
I can't say that on video. I'm just going to say it's a lot of fun. It's a really fun lift.
But we need to know. Enjoy it. We need to know the correct technical name.
And of course, I'm an operator, not an engineer, so it's just a lot of fun. You'll love it.
I'm going to call it a diagonal lift. There we go. There we go. Thank you, Steve. All right.
Cheers, mate. Thanks a lot. Right. Great
Cheers.
To see
Bye.
You.
Bye. So if you're taking the escalators, there are three there. We found out, by the way, the official phrase is incline lift, so it's not inclinator. There's actually a clip actually from the press trip that I never used, so here's an outtake where Mark Wilde actually discusses why it's not called a funicular.
No, it's not a funicular for one reason.
Oh.
A funicular goes up and down, yeah. So like that. That's a funicular.
So we're calling it an incline lift.
And the clever thing is, this is literally a lift shaft on its side.
Sarah, so I think there's a regular lift, and then that will then take us to the incline lift.
Thank you very much.
That one?
Yeah, you've done an inclinator before, right?
Yeah, not this one.
You've done the one at Greenford?
Yeah.
Where else have you done an inclinator?
That's it.
That's it. All right.
It's exciting every time.
Controversy. At Liverpool Street, the actual gate line, where the lovely MTR staff. In the press video, I was saying, remember, it's platform A for Abbey Wood and B for Berkshire, but Tim has come up with...
A for the Abbey, B for the Bear.
B for the Bear. That is amazing. Let's do that. B for the Bear. At the Bishop's Gate ticket gate line hall entrance, that one, there are more escalators and another, smaller, shorter, where is it? There it is. There's another incline lift that takes you out to that entrance up there, but Sarah and I are going to go through that one down there. Okay, so this is the western end exit. You come out here, that brings you by the escalators that take you down and up from the central line there and the subsurface platforms there. Sarah's here. Sarah, do you know where the lift is to exit? I can't remember where it is.
I'm working on it.
We've made it to Liverpool Street main concourse. How was your step-free experience?
Amazing.
Amazing?
Really,
wow.
It really was.
So you thought the wayfinding was good?
Yes.
But you wanted what? Maybe some floor stickers you think might help?
Yes, yeah.
What else? Tell YouTube.
Oh, I especially enjoyed the incline lift. Okay. So much fun.
So there's one long one here, then a short one, and there's two at... Farringdon. And we didn't actually go on a train, did we? So I feel like in a minute we should go back.
Because we want to
check that the gap for actually boarding the train is okay as well.
Yeah.
But you did it the other day, didn't you?
I did.
You were here on Tuesday.
I did it with my friend that uses a power wheelchair.
Your friend in a power wheelchair had no problems?
That's right.
And you in a manual wheelchair, you had no problems?
Yeah.
You think the gap's okay?
We found it, so yes.
Okay, all right. I'll do a little cutaway of Sarah getting on, showing that the wheelchair is good with the gap. So thanks very much. Nice to see you again.
Not a problem.
You're going to buy me a coffee now?
Yes.
I've only had like 3 coffees today.
Oh, no. I need
4.
You need more.
I need more.
Coffee level low. Yeah.
My caffeine level is falling. That is it. That is the end of day 5. It feels like a series now.
The next video will be Whitechapel. Coming soon.
Day 6. Press subscribe.
Press subscribe.
Thanks. Bye.
Bye.